Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about the index operator in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, people, let's begin. I'm going to be explaining the index operator, which is represented by a set of square brackets. Now, they give access to a sequence's elements. They include, but are not limited to, strings, lists, and tuples. For this example, we're going to be working with strings because strings are easy to work with. Let's say we have a name, and name equals whatever your first and last name is. We can use the index operator to access an element of the sequence, our string. So let's check to see if the first letter in our name is lowercase, and I should probably change that to lowercase for this example. So within an if statement, if name, and we can add a set of square brackets after our sequence, which is a string, and we can check a given element of our sequence. Let's check to see if the first letter is lowercase. Now, with computers, they always start at zero. If you need to access the first element in a sequence, that would be index zero. And then the next sequence, well, the next element in the sequence would be one, then two, then you follow that pattern. So I would like to check to see if name at index zero, that would be the first character, is lowercase. So there is a method to check that. Dot is lower. This will return true or false. If the first letter is lowercase, then our if statement is going to be resolved to true. And what I could do is that I can perhaps change it to uppercase then. So let's reassign name to equal name dot, and there is a capitalize function here. And then let's print our name. Print name. So when we run this, the first letter in my name is now capitalized. So if you need to access an element within a sequence, a string or a list or a tuple, you would add a set of square brackets afterwards, and then you list an integer of the element that you're trying to access. So here's a few other examples. I'm going to turn this as well as this into a comment. And let's say we would like to create some substrings, and we can do so using our index operator. So I would like to create a substring from the first part of my name. So what I'll do is create a new variable, first name equals name index operator. So you can specify a range for an index operator. So you would set the starting position on the left-hand side, followed by a colon, and then your ending position. So I would like this substring to begin at index 0 and end at 3. So that would be 0, colon, then 3. All right. And then I would like to make this all uppercase for some reason. And then let's print my first name. So with the index operator, we specified a range. We would like to access elements 0 through 3. Turn them uppercase and assign them to a new variable of first name. Here's a shortcut that you might find useful. If the index for your range begins with 0, you can actually delete that. You don't even necessarily need that 0. Now we just have colon 3, and this would work the same as it did before. So that's a useful shortcut, and we're going to bring it up later if we need to access the last element in a sequence. This time, let's create a substring of last name. So last name equals name index operator. This time, I would like to access the element at index, let's see, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so I'm going to say 4, colon, and we're not really sure where our name, our last name, is going to end. So what you could do is just say colon and then leave the next index blank. So that will be the index beginning at 4 and everything afterwards. And let's say 2 lower to make this all lowercase for some reason. So let's print our last name. Print last name. So this should take everything starting at index 4 and after that and turn it into its own substring of last name. Now you can access the last element in a sequence by using what's called negative indexing. So let's add an exclamation point to the end of our name. So let's say we have a new variable called last character. And I would like to store the last character in my name to this new variable, this new substring. So to access the last element in a sequence within the index operator, we can use negative indexing. So the last element would be -1. All right. And then let's print whatever our last character is. So this should print an exclamation point. Yep, which it did. So then if this was -2, that would be the second to last element in a sequence. So now that would be E, because E is in the second to last element in my sequence. All right, everybody, so that's the basics of the index operator. You can add a set of square brackets after a string, a list, or a tuple, and then list an integer or a range of the elements that you're trying to access. So if you would like a copy of all this code, I will post everything in the comments down below. Don't be afraid to help me out and smash that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.